Welcome to Quick Literature Academy. Subscribe and press the bell icon for more literature videos. Old English period 450 to 1066. It begins with the invasion of Celtic England by Germanic tribes Angles, Saxons, Jutes and Frisians around 450 and lasts until the conquest of England by the Norman French William the Conqueror in 1066. Writing of this time was primarily religious verse or prose. Major writers or works: poetry by Beowulf, The Wanderer, The Seafarer, Dior. Prose: writings of Alfred the Great. Middle English period 1066 to 1500. After the Norman invasion, there were linguistic, social and cultural changes and also changes in the literature. In the 15th century, literature aimed at a popular audience grew. A range of genres emerged, including chivalric romances, secular and religious songs, folk ballads, drama, morality and miracle plays. Major writers or works: Sir Gawain and the Green Knight, Dream of the Rood, William Langland's Pious Ploughman. Lyrics such as The Cuckoo Song, Summer is Coming in prose, Sir Thomas Malory's Morte d'Arthur, Geoffrey Chaucer's Canterbury Tales, Julian of Norwich, Margery Kemp's The Book of Margery Kemp, drama, The Second Play of the Shepherds, Everyman. The Renaissance, the early modern period 1500 to 1660. The Renaissance, meaning rebirth, is used broadly to refer to the flourishing of literature, paintings, culture and architecture and learning in general that began in Italy in the 14th century. The Renaissance period in British literature spans the years 1500 to 1660 and is usually divided into five subsections: Early Tudor, Elizabethan, Jacobean, Caroline, Commonwealth or Puritan Interregnum. The Early Tudor period 1500 to 1558. The early Tudor period is the first phase of the Renaissance period. The period is known for its poetry and non-fiction prose. English literature's first dramatic comedy, Ralph Royster Doyster, was first performed in 1553. Major writers or works: poetry, John Skelton, Henry Howard, the Earl of Surrey, Sir Thomas Watt. Prose, Sir Thomas More's Utopia, Sir Thomas Eliot. Drama, John Heywood, Nicholas Udall, Ralph Royster Doyster. Elizabethan age 1558 to 1603. The second era of the Renaissance period in British literature spanning the reign of Elizabeth I. The Elizabethan era was a period marked by developments in English commerce, nationalism, exploration and maritime power. It is considered a great age in literary history, particularly for drama. Major writers or works: poetry by Sir Philip Sidney, Edmund Spenser's The Faerie Queen, Elizabeth I, William Shakespeare. Prose, Francis Bacon, Sir Walter Raleigh. Drama, Christopher Marlowe's The Jew of Malta, William Shakespeare again, and Thomas Kyd's The Spanish Tragedy. Jacobean age 1603 to 1625. The third era of the Renaissance period in British literature is defined by the reign of James I. In this era, there were significant writings in prose, including the King James Bible. Drama and poetry also flourished. Major writers or works: poetry by John Donne, George Chapman, Lady Mary Wroth. Prose by Francis Bacon, Robert Burton. Drama by William Shakespeare, Ben Jonson, John Webster, John Fletcher, Thomas Middleton and George Chapman. Caroline age 1625 to 1649. The Caroline age marks the period of the English Civil War between the supporters of the King Charles called Cavaliers and the supporters of Parliament called the Roundheads. Literature of this period featured poetry, non-fiction prose and the cavalier poets who were associated with the court and wrote poems of gallantry and courtship. Major writers or works: poetry by John Milton, George Herbert, cavalier poets Richard Lovelace, Sir John Suckling, Thomas Carew and Robert Herrick. Prose by Robert Burton, Sir Thomas Browne. Drama by Philip Messenger, John Forbes. This Commonwealth or Puritan Interregnum 1649 to 1658. In this era, England was ruled by Parliament and Oliver Cromwell and then briefly by his son Richard until 1859. Theatres were closed on moral and religious grounds. While drama did not flourish, significant examples of non-fiction prose and poetry were written during this period. Major writers or works: poetry by John Milton, Andrew Marvell, Henry Vaughan, Edmund Waller, Abraham Cowley, Catherine Phillips. Prose by Thomas Hobbes Leviathan, Sir Thomas Browne, Isaac Walton, Thomas Fuller, Jeremy Taylor. New classical period 1660 to 1785. The new classical period is often divided into three sub-areas: the Restoration Age, the Augustan Era, and the Age of Sensibility. The Restoration Era 1660 to 1700. The Restoration Era begins with the crowning of Charles II and the restoration of the Stuart line in 1660 and ends around 1700. After the Puritan ban on theatres was lifted, theatre came back into prominence. Drama of this period frequently focused upon the aristocracy and the life of the court and is characterized by its use of urbanity, wit, and immoral plot lines. Major writers or works: poetry by John Milton, Paradise Lost, John Dryden, Samuel Butler; prose, Samuel Pepys' Diary, John Bunyan's Pilgrim's Progress, John Dryden, Isaac Newton's Principle of Mathematics; novels, Aphra Behn's Orinoco; drama, Sir George Etheridge, William Congreve's The Way of the World; Aphra Behn's The Rover. The Augustan Era, 1700 to 1745. Many writers in this period identified themselves with the writers in the age of Roman Emperor Augustus. Augustan writers imitated the literary forms of Horace, Virgil, and Ovid, and drew upon the perceived order, decorum, moderation, civility, and wit of these writers. Major writers or works: poetry, Alexander Pope, John Gay, Jonathan Swift; prose, Richard Steele, Joseph Addison, Alexander Pope, Eliza Haywood, Lady Mary Wortley Montagu. Novels, Samuel Richardson's Pamela, Daniel Defoe's Robinson Crusoe, Jonathan Swift's Gulliver's Travels. Drama, Henry Fielding, John Gay's The Beggar's Opera. The Age of Sensibility, 1744 to 1798. The Age of Sensibility is precursor of the Romantic period. In contrast to the Augustan era, the Age of Sensibility focused upon instinct, feeling, imagination, and sometimes the sublime. New cultural attitudes and new theories of literature emerged at this time. The novel became an increasingly popular and prevalent form. Ideas such as new classicism, a critical and literary mode, and the Enlightenment, a particular worldview shared by many intellectuals, were championed during this age. Major writers or works: poetry by Thomas Gray, William Collins, Christopher Smart, William Cowper, Anne Finch, Mary Leeper; prose, Samuel Johnson's Essays and Dictionary, Edmund Burke, James Boswell; novels, Samuel Richardson, Tobias Smollett, Henry Fielding, Laurence Sterne, Frances Burney; drama, Oliver Goldsmith's She Stoops to Conquer, Richard Brinsley's Sheridan's The School of Scandal. The Romantic Period, 1798 to 1837. Many writers in this Romantic period emphasized feeling and imagination and looked toward nature for insight into the divine. The individual and his or her subjective experiences and expressions of those experiences were highly valued. Many scholars see the artistic aesthetic freedoms in Romanticism in contrast to the ideas of New Classicism. In addition to a wealth of poetry, the Romantic period featured significant innovations in the novel form, including the Gothic novel. Major writers or works: poetry by Roman Burns, William Blake, William Wordsworth, Samuel Taylor Coleridge, Lord Byron, P.B. Shelley, John Keats, Helen Maria Williams, Anne Laetitia Barbauld; prose, Mary Wollstonecraft, Mary Princess, The History of Mary Prince, Charles Lamb, Dorothy Wordsworth; novels by Jane Austen, Sir Walter Scott, Mary Shelley's Frankenstein, Matthew Gregory Lewis, The Monk, Anne Radcliffe; drama, Joanna Baillie. The Victorian period, 1837 to 1901. Early Victorian literature is that written before 1870. Late Victorian literature is that written after 1870. Varied in form, style, and content, Victorian literature reflects a changing social, political, and economic and cultural climate. Industrialization, urbanization, technological advances, and economic and political changes are just a few of the forces reflected in Victorian literature. Recurrent issues include poverty, class, gender, philosophy, and religious issues. Major writers or works: poetry, Alfred Lord Tennyson, Robert Browning, Elizabeth Barrett Browning, Gerard Manley Hopkins; prose, Thomas Carlyle, John Ruskin, Walter Pater, Florence Nightingale, Francis Power Cobb, Charles Darwin; novels, Charlotte Bronte, Emily Bronte, Charles Dickens, George Eliot, Thomas Hardy, Anthony Trollope, William Makepeace Thackeray, Elizabeth Gaskell; drama, Tom Taylor, Gilbert and Sullivan, एच जे बायरन। प्री राल्फाइटिज्म 1848 to 1850s, the pre-Raphaelite Brotherhood was formed by a group of visual artists who attempted to return painting to the simplicity and truthfulness of art before the High Renaissance, a period of artistic production that is viewed by art historians as the height or the culmination of the Renaissance period. Major writers or works of this period: poetry, Dante Gabriel Rossetti, Christiana Rossetti's Goblin Market, William Morris, Charles Algernon Swinburne. Aestheticism, or the Aesthetic Movement, 1880 to 1900. Aestheticism is a literary and visual art movement in late 19th century Europe. Centered on a belief in art for art's sake, aestheticism believed that art was not meant to serve moral or directive or purpose. Art's value was in its beauty. Major writers: Charles Algernon Swinburne, Oscar Wilde, Lionel Johnson, Arthur Symons, Walter Pater. Decadence, 1880 to 1900. British decadents embraced the idea of creating art for its own sake, pursuing all possible desires and seeking material excess. At the same time, they were not shy about using the tools of decadence for social and political purpose. Decadence was concerned with unconventional artistic forms and ideas. Followers often led unconventional lives. Major writers: Ernest Dowson, Arthur Symons, Lionel Johnson, Oscar Wilde. Edwardian period, 1901 to 1910, a period of British literature named by the reign of Edward VII and referring to literature published after the Victorian period and before World War I. The Edwardian period is not characterized by a consistent style or theme or genre. The term generally refers to a historical period rather than a literary style. Major writers: poetry, William Butler Yeats, Rudyard Kipling. Prose, Arnold Bennett, Ford Madox Ford, Alfred Noyes. Novels, Thomas Hardy, Joseph Conrad, Henry James, H.G. Wells, Ford Madox Ford, James Galsworthy. Drama, George Bernard Shaw, John M. Synge, William Butler Yeats, James Perry. The Georgian period, 1910 to 1936. The Georgian period usually refers to the reign of George V, 1910 to 1936, but also sometimes includes the reigns of the four successive Georges from 1714 to 1830. Georgian poetry today is typically considered to be the works of minor poets anthologized by Edward Marsh. The themes and subject matter tended to be rural or pastoral in nature, treated delicately and traditionally rather than with passion or with experimentation. Major poets: Ralph Hodgson, John Masefield, W.H. Davis, Rupert Brooke. Modern period, 1914 to 1939. Appeared in British and American literature spanning the years between World War I and World War II. Works in this period reflect the changing social, political, and cultural climate and are diverse, experimental, and non-traditional. W.B. Yeats' words, "Things fall apart, the center cannot hold," are often referred to when describing the core tenet or feeling of modernist concerns. Major writers: poetry, Wilfred Owen, W.H. Auden, A.E. Housman, T.S. Eliot, Marianne Moore. Prose, Virginia Woolf, Catherine Mansfield, T.S. Eliot. Novels, Joseph Conrad, James Joyce, E.M. Forrester, Virginia Woolf, Evelyn Waugh, D.H. Lawrence. Drama, Sean O'Casey, William Butler Yeats, George Bernard Shaw. Postmodern contemporary period, 1939 to present. In British literature and American literature, the postmodern period refers to literature written after World War II. Post-culturalist literary theory and criticism developed during this time. The postmodern period reflects anxieties concerning and reactions to life in the 20th century. Postmodern works are often highly experimental and anti-conventional. Major writers: poetry, Edith Sitwell, Dylan Thomas, Louis MacNeice, Philip Larkin, Ted Hughes, Stevie Smith, Seamus Heaney, Evan Boland. Prose, George Orwell, Janet Winterson, Martin Amis. Novels, George Orwell, William Golding, Doris Lessing, Margaret Drabble, Graham Greene, John Fowles, Iris Murdoch, Ian McEwan, A.S. Bitt, Salman Rushdie, V.S. Naipaul. Drama, Samuel Beckett, Noel Coward, Tom Stoppard, Harold Pinter, Carol Churchill. Thanks for watching. Do subscribe for more videos.